Last year, because of what happened to us, we couldn't celebrate this day. But today, we thank God for His mercy that we are able to be here. I just want to say that if you look at the program, page 7 is where I have my seat. I will not bore you reading through it. Praise the Lord. Yes, Mark upon the word of page 7. Yaka. And I want to say that I want to thank every man in this church. And when we started, it was like a dream. I remember that that was in May last year, the second Sunday of May, the very great ceremony, the doctor came and called me and a few others that we could take over the reins of the main fellowship. You know, and then we started. And then as we started, we prayed that God should let the remnants of what is made for us have its roots underneath and have the roots of fruit of the world. In our men, in the army, this celebration is big. Yet now, we know that if you were not there, it would have not been possible. I have enjoyed splendid encouragement from all the men. From my God, I am looking like the smallest man, and truly I am the smallest. In terms of everything, I am the least in everything. But I thank God because it pleases me to use me to be the one that is championing the peace of men, bringing men to Christ. And with humble steps, I want to thank the women. If you look at the eyes, when I look at the eyes of the women, I could see the encouragement. I could see the do it, you can do it. Some stop you and they say, look, do it. I did it, you're going to do it. And thank God. And the youth, our children, I want you to know that the women here are our wives, the mothers of our own children, which are the youth. And you look into the eyes of the kid, you can see the little smile that you know passes through there. And you now see that, yes, you can do it. So I want to thank everybody. Without you, I will not do anything. And I thank that you have been here to support me. So thank you very much. And then more, I give God the glory. I thank God that He has given me an opportunity to be able to stand here and say, oh, come, let's go save the Lord. That is why this week, we want to serve the Lord more. We want to do more service in the house of God. And just as the minister said this morning, quarrelable men, they that could be put into the quarry. And so, I am challenging you that you have to, this is the 19th of June. Being the 19th of June, we begin our next calendar. Let's call it, this is the new year for men. May it stop. Let this be the beginning of our day, beginning of our year, so that we begin to count our year from the day we start, we are finished celebrating men's fasting. You know, that is to say that from 20th of June 2016, we have to begin to celebrate and evaluate ourselves. Let us look at ourselves. Let us see how we do things in the house of God. Let us see how we can put more time, you know, in serving the Lord. Praise the Lord. And then, of course, you know that by the time we serve God that week, by the time we evaluate ourselves more, we will know where what we can do in the house of God. Praise the Lord. And I want you to understand that even Hezekiah, when he was that sick, as the one that I've been, Peter, Peter, Peter. Good morning. And you go, Abba, you go, Abba, the master of prophesy, I don't go in here. He's here, go now, go back, go back. You can so say, Richard, that's why I will be the same thing as the other day, so. Same thing as I'm born of him. And so you see, if you look at that portion, you see that in verse 8, chapter 8, we have the things that Hezekiah did. Are you there?
But now, what I want us to understand is that let us put ourselves in the house of God and work with God. Let's do that. Let us talk about the conclusion of the future. Brethren, in this next another year of quiet job, the way of God, begin from here. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. Love also your neighbor as yourself. Go and go, say the Lord, and I will help you speak and will teach you what to say. If you read down, you will see. I don't know much, but what I want us to do, let us begin to live a life differently. So that we will be able to show our children an example. Let us be the father or the man that God has made us to be. So once again, I want to thank you so much. Thank you for all the contributions you've given. You know, you have given money, a lot of people give money, people spend their time, and they come out. We had a wonderful program yesterday, and we had a wonderful program in the morning. And I want to thank some of us, like Brock, okay, for all the bills, you know, the many dollars stuff. I have enjoyed so much from you. I want to plead with you, please, let us continue to work together, to save God together. I also want to thank the minister for what he has done. He spent his time with us. If I tell you, it's just like you hear with us and he's been there for us. So please, may I want to say congratulations one more time for the celebration of our policy. Today is our day. Thank you for coming. God bless everybody. I agree with you.